Hello students and welcome back. Today we will do grammar topic tenses. Already we have done literature part, 3 chapters from first flight, 3 chapters from footprints without feet and 3 poems. So this is time for learning something related to grammar. So our first topic is tenses. In this topic I am going to teach you all tenses in English language. So are you ready? So let's start. So tenses, basically there are 3 times. Okay, what are the times? Here is present, past and future. So these are the times and there are 4 aspects. What are the 4 aspects? The 4 aspects are simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous. So basically in English language what happens? When the 3 times combine with these 4 aspects, then they form tenses. Okay, like for example, present time is combined with simple aspect, so it forms present simple tense. So in this way we can form all parts of the tenses, like present simple, present continuous, present perfect and present perfect continuous. Same as we can form from the past as well. Like if we combine the time past with the aspect simple, that will become past simple, past continuous, past perfect and past perfect continuous. Same we can do with the future. Future simple, future continuous, future perfect and future perfect continuous. So basically in English language there are total in 12 tenses. Okay, so 12 all tenses we would do. How we would do? First of all, let's start with the present simple. Okay, so let's start first of all present simple tense. So first of all, I would tell you the sentence formation for this. How we can form the sentence? We can take subject plus verb first form, okay, and then object. In the case when the subject is I, we, they, we follow this sentence formation. But if the subject starts with he, she, it or any name, then what would be the sentence formation? Earlier we have just written verb first form, but if it starts with he, she, it or any name, then we would add s or es with the verb form, that is verb first form, and then comes your object. So I am giving the example, okay, so you can better understand it. So first of all, let's understand present simple where we use. Generally we use the present simple tense to mention the habits and routines. Okay, so what are the habits and routines? Like suppose she cooks food. So there is no need to write down every day because she cooks food. This is the habit and routine. So this is she cooks food. So you note down when I am using she, I have used s with verb first form. So let me put one another example. We play football. Okay, so we play football. Now note down, here I have used we. So I have told you earlier that when we use the subject as we, they, okay, plural means. So we only use verb first form. So please remember this. When you are having the subject as singular, you would use verb first form, s or es. But when you are having the subject plural, you would use only verb first form. Okay, singular, s or es, plural, only verb first form. So this is the sentence formation of present simple tense. So this is present simple tense. First use is habit and routine. Now what is the second use of it? Second use of it, that when we are mentioning any fact. Okay, what kind of fact? Like if I write down sun rises in the east. So this is a fact. So here I have used present simple. You can note down here rises. Okay, fine. So verb first form s or es we have applied. So this is the fact. So basically we use present simple with habit and routine plus facts. Okay, so this is the present simple. Suppose we need to form the negative of it. So how we can form the negative sentence? Okay, present simple negative. So we would take subject plus do or does according to the subject. As I have told you, if subject is he, she or it, you will apply does. If subject is I, we, they, you will apply do. Okay, plus not. Okay, because we are forming the negative. Then comes your verb. Now there is no need to apply s or es. Please note down, because already we have applied the helping verb do and does. So there is no need to apply anything with verb first form. It would be as it is. Then comes your object. Like she does not know how to dance. Okay, yeah, she does not know me. So this is also one example. Fine, if we are going to understand with the plural, they do not help others. They do not help others. So they. So I have applied do not. So I think this is the best understanding you can do. Subject, if it is plural, do not. Subject, if singular, does not. Fine. And only verb first form. Then comes the interrogative. First of all, let us understand the meaning of interrogative. When you are asking something, okay, question sentences are called interrogative sentences. So if I am going to form interrogative sentence, so how I would form it? First of all, I will place do and does. Do with we, they, okay, and plural subject. Does with she, it, he or any name. Then comes your subject. Then comes verb first form. Then comes your object. And because it is interrogative, you are asking something, so question mark. Fine. So do. Do they know you? Suppose you are asking someone, okay, do they know you? Does she complete her work? Or does she go to school? So you can also put like this. So note down when you are asking. So with plural you are applying do, with singular you are applying does. So this is the present simple tense. Fine. So when we are combining the time present with the aspect simple, we have formed present simple tense. Let's move to the another one. Next is present continuous. Present continuous. So this tense basically tells you the action happening now. Okay, this is not about the general actions. So basically verb is called an action. So what is verb? Verb is action. So this is the action which is happening now. So this tense is about the present moment. Okay, what is happening now? And moreover, we can use this tense as to show temporary activities. Okay, so let us understand the sentence formation first. Subject is am, are plus verb first form plus ing and then comes object. So suppose the subject is I, we use am with it. Okay, if the subject is we or they, we will apply are. If the subject starts with he, she, it or any name, we will apply is with this. So this is we are going to understand first, where we have to apply am, where we have to apply is and where we have to apply are. So this is the sentence formation. I'm again telling you I, okay, with I, am, we, they, plural, we apply are, with you also, he, she, it or any name, we apply is. Okay, so now I'm telling you present. Okay, present, what is happening now? What is happening now? I am writing. Okay, on board. Fine. So this is the action happening now. So I have applied, I am writing on board. Fine. So let us understand. Suppose we are talking about the temporary activities. What are the temporary activities? It's for a short period of time. Fine. Like she is learning to speak French. She is learning to speak French. Okay, you can name anyone. Fine. Like Ria is learning to speak French. So this is the temporary activity. Fine. It will for the short period of time. Fine. So with this also we are applying present continuous. So let us understand the negative sentence formation. For forming a negative sentence, okay, so what is the sentence formation? Subject, okay, is am, are, then add not. Fine, not, because we are forming the negative. Fine, then comes your verb first form plus ing and then comes your object. Let me put some example here. He is not doing his work. Fine. This is the negative sentence formation. Okay. Now let's understand the interrogative. Interrogative sentence formation. Okay. Again, when you are asking something, so you need to place the helping verbs first. So is, am, are, any of this. Okay. If we are using the singular, then is. If I am applying I, then am. If we are using any of the subject like we, they, you, okay, then are. Then comes subject, then verb first form plus ing and then comes object. And don't put full stop, put question mark. Okay, because we are forming the interrogative. When helping verbs comes as first, you need to put question mark. So
is Rahu attending the meeting? Okay. Are you watching any new series nowadays? Are you watching any new series nowadays? This is also one example. Fine. So now you have understood what is present continuous. We can also use this tense while talking about the changes taking place around us. How? Like Netflix is very trending today. Okay. Is trending nowadays. Netflix is trending nowadays. So this is a trend, changes which are taking place. So when we are talking about such kind of actions, we always apply present continuous. So I hope it is clear. Now let's move to the next one. Now present time, and we will take the aspect perfect. So present time, aspect perfect. When we are using the present perfect, present perfect is a tense form we use with the experienced things. You have experienced something, you are explaining it with present perfect. Or we can also use when we are talking about any recent action or event. Okay, so let me first of all tell you the sentence formation. So what is the sentence formation? Very easy to understand. Subject comes first, then has or have. Again I am telling you, has, when the subject starts with he, she, it or any name, then has. Okay. And have, suppose the subject is starting with we, they, you, then we can apply have. Better understand this, because this is very important. Fine. So we are applying in this way, and then has, have always comes a third form, and then comes object. Fine. So when the action you have experienced or you are talking about any recent event, okay, so we are using present perfect. Perfect means completely done. Like I have finished my lunch. This is the event recently taken place. Okay, so we are describing it. Now experience. Okay, Parul has visited Delhi. It is her experience. She has already visited Delhi. Or they have seen this movie. Okay, they have already seen, they have already experienced. So this is how we are explaining it. Present perfect, when the action is recently done and finished. So that is present perfect. Don't ever mix it with past, because sometimes it really puzzles you as action is done. Fine. So you can even misconcept it with past. But present perfect, when some experience which is recently done, okay, action which is recently finished, we are using present perfect with it. So now comes the negative sentence formation. How we can form subject? Okay, then comes has, have plus not. Okay, and then comes your verb third form, and then comes your object. I have not seen him. Fine. I have not seen him. She has not prepared for the meeting. She has not prepared for the meeting. So these are the negative sentence formation. Now let's understand the interrogative. Interrogative sentence formation, as I have told you, helping verb first, has have, then you come with the subject, and then comes your verb third form, then comes object, and comes question mark. Fine. So have you seen this movie before? You are asking, have you seen this movie before? So this is the interrogative. Has she cooked the meal? Has she cooked the meal? So again you are asking. So has and have we have used in these sentences. Fine. So this is present perfect tense. So let us understand next aspect, present perfect continuous. So next aspect is present perfect continuous. Present perfect continuous, basically when we are talking about an action which has started in the past, still in continuity, so that is present perfect continuous. So it was started in the past but still in continuity, so we would apply both the things, verb third form and ing, which is denoting continuous. Fine. So what would be the sentence formation? Subject. Okay. Has, have, plus been. Been is denoting the perfect, verb third form. Okay. And then comes, because we are mentioning the continuous, so verb first form plus ing. And then comes your object. But one more thing is to add in it. That is time reference. Since and for. Since or for, we are using it. Okay. With object. After this, since and for. Where we are using the since? Fine. Since point of time. Since with the point of time. And for period of time. Fine. So you better understand this since and for, because when we are referring present perfect continuous, we are just mentioning these time phrases. So let us understand with the example here. They have been watching TV since morning. So you have a point of time. Okay. Since morning. Today morning. Okay. So if I write, she has been watching TV for 2 hours. Now let us understand why I have written the same sentence with the different subject, to better know about how we are using it. First of all, let us understand the use of has and have, which is very clear. Okay, as the subject starts with they or we or you, we are using have. When the subject is singular, she, it, name, okay, then has. Now come to since and for. Since morning, you know, today is morning. For 2 hours, you are not decided for 2 hours. Okay, it is starting, it could be evening, okay, it could be night. So we are not have any point in this time, okay. So this is a period of time, so that's why we are using for, and this is point of time, that's why we are using since. Same if we are forming the negative, they have not been watching. If we are forming the interrogative, have they been watching? So these are the sentence formation for present perfect continuous, as I have told you how we can use. Okay, so this is present tense. I hope this video is very useful for you to understand the tenses. Thank you and have a nice day.